No Notes.
All right. Hello, hello, and guess who's back? It's No Notes.
Guess who's back?
How we doing? How we doing? Well,
great, great, great.
Here we are. We mentioned a couple of episodes ago how great things have to come to an end, but we're only coming to an end for the 2014 season.
Yeah, don't get it twisted.
Yeah, we'll be back for some more next year, but we'll talk about that a little bit before we close out.
Right.
But just thinking about the year, another great year. We feel as though we're continuously progressing, and that development is wonderful. We have some new fans. We've made some accomplishments. We are getting better at what we do in terms of our video quality and things like that. And people have been sharing their feedback and supporting us. We have launched a couple campaigns, which we're getting nice support on. So we've been busy this year.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. No doubt.
We've been busy. And we always like to, what we like to do here at the end of the year, we always like to reflect on the not only just the year, but people that have really contributed to the No Notes Show and have always done that from day one. And so we're going to mention some names, but please, please don't be offended if we just so happen to forget about someone.
Exactly, exactly.
You are always in our thoughts.
No doubt, no doubt, yes.
You are always in our thoughts. So first, I'd like to thank Michelle Snow.
Oh, no doubt. Oh, yes.
And the
yes,
Michelle Snow yes. Company. Yes. Wonderful lady, consistently supporting us. She directs people our way to interview and to connect with. And, you know, she's just been a tremendous part of who we are now today.
Really?
So we owe a lot to her, you know, and she's been always helpful and providing good advice and sound direction for us.
Right.
As well as connecting us with some great people. Like most recently, Harvey Lockridge. I mean, good man, family man, wonderful story. But she's connected with quite a few people that...
that was a profound story.
Oh, yeah. I think we put that as one of our most powerful stories.
Yes.
Or interviews that we have done in our attention.
Amazing man. Amazing.
So, I mean, you know, but... She's just a fantastic person. I mean, she's moving up in the world, too. Check her out on Facebook. She's getting ready to make a nice transition down to Center City area, JFK Boulevard. And she's going to be at her new location. There's an open house coming up for her. So please, again, her name is Michelle Snow.
Yeah.
The Michelle Snow Network is on Facebook. The Michelle Snow Company LLC is on Facebook. Check her out.
We can't mention Michelle without mentioning the green room.
I know. That takes us back. I mean,
what's the
Fran, Daddy, and the crew?
But the organization. What's the young lady's name?
Lynn D. Management.
Lynn
D. Management is the company.
Yes.
Another fantastic interview. Good people.
Good. Very good people.
Good people.
They on a mission.
Yeah. Another person that we got connected with through Michelle is Nadetra Patrick.
Oh yes.
And she has evolved. She's now married. Congratulations.
Yes, I did all that.
But she's moved on. I mean, because when we first connected with her, we visited her at her parents' church.
True.
Now she has her own church. So she's really come.
Yes, the last time we visited her
was at her own church on Marshall Street, 15th and Marshall. In Philadelphia. So
she don't let grass grow under her feet. I mean, she's always
on the move. Very, very driven. Very, very motivated, very driven.
I'm happy for her.
And we are definitely happy for her. She's found someone special to be a part of her life, and that's wonderful. But, I mean, just it's because of Michelle that these people have been brought to us, and they're established relationships now. Built to last, that's what we always say.
Built to last.
Built to last.
No doubt about it.
Another true strong advocate for the No Notes Show supporter. Can't forget about the infamous Rick Coley. Yeah. And now that's entertainment crew, the crew at Now That's Entertainment.
I don't know where the genuflex and kiss the ring. Rick's the man.
Rick Coley. Another very hard working person. I mean, to the point where you got to tell him.
Exactly. This man works so hard. He skipped meals.
Right. Yeah. And that's not good. So we definitely, yeah. we got to call you out a little bit because you be misbehaving when you don't eat.
We want you to eat, brother. We want you to keep doing what you do.
But always doing great things, you know, bringing great acts to you. People such as Sinbad.
The Songbird.
Cannot forget about his wife, the Songbird.
That's right. Shilla Songbird. Yeah.
The Stylistics, Larry Graham, just to name a few. I mean, he puts together a nice package.
Harold Melvin,
the Blue Notes. Yeah. You know, so in between here, locally, Philadelphia,
Jersey,
and New York, and down in Delaware, too. So he's all over. I mean, he just back and forth, moving.
Hard to hit a moving target. Yeah.
And all to entertain you.
Right.
So,
right,
exactly, I mean, but exactly. Fantastic guy. I mean, he has paved the way for us to get connected with some of the artists and comedians that I just mentioned. C.P. Lacey, Sinbad,
yes.
and some great acts, some great performers. So he's definitely
what about Rockman?
Rockman Watts.
Rockman,
and Keith Rockshell.
Keith Rockshell, exactly.
Yeah, so, yeah. I mean, so just to name a few. So, yeah. I mean, hats off to Rick, you know, and what he's done.
Amazing, man.
Thank you, Rick. And we continue to grow together, you know, so... I mean, but, and some of our personal accomplishments, one thing that we reached a milestone, we reached our 100th episode this year.
Yes.
And that's tough.
Who would have thunk it?
You think
2009, what was 2009?
You think 100 is a small, could be, by comparison, could be a small number. But when you're in this business and trying to attain 100 episodes, that's tough. Coming up with material.
It's a grind.
Yeah. Coming up with material, topics and things, different things to do to keep it fresh and vibrant. That's a tough thing. It's not easy. We got to our 100th episode, and we're beyond the 100th episode now.
We
met that goal, we surpassed it.
Exceeded it.
So, and you know, another goal we're still working on, and there's still a little time left. I mean, we hope to reach, we're looking to reach 300 dedicated fans on our business page. So we're getting close.
We're getting close.
But we have grown on our group page as well. So they're both on Facebook. So, and we made a major change to our website this year, the new look. That was more towards the beginning of 2014.
Okay, good.
The new look, the new style, we got nice feedback on that, and we love the new look because it compliments who we are and what we do.
Exactly,
So that was a major change for us. So we've been busy doing some things too, you know, and of course getting around to meeting with people and doing interviews and doing our shows and you know, taking care of those things. It's been a nice year in 2014.
No doubt about it. You know what I'm thinking about.
What's that?
I'm thinking about the Barlows.
The Barlows, that's right.
Whew. Barlows.
Finally, we got Janine Barlow on the show. And that was another one.
Yes.
Another powerful interview.
Yes. Very powerful young lady. Yeah.
Now we talked about this on the show. We were planning to get both of them on the same show together.
No, that's going to be a milestone.
That's going to be hot.
That might
be a mini series.
Man. That's going to be a milestone, man.
But Janine, powerful motivator.
I'm in the process of ordering her book off of
Amazon. Don't be scared. Be Speak is the book.
Yeah.
Motivating people to get a better quality of life. That's what she's all about. That's what they're all about together.
Exactly.
You know, Omar in the education field, I mean, you know, doing a fantastic job at Eastern University Charter School.
Charter School.
Up on Lehigh Avenue in Philadelphia. I mean, doing the work he's doing with those kids, tremendous work. And, you can see the value and the benefits.
No doubt.
And so that's a fantastic job.
It's just I was speaking to Janine for a brief moment and saying to her, it's amazing they can't get that curriculum in public school.
I know.
That's a hell of a curriculum they have for them kids.
Mm-hmm. I mean, setting them up right now for college bound. I mean, but really setting them up.
They doing business, business proposals.
Oh, proposals and projects. And I mean, you know.
Fundraising.
Nice. It's nice. I mean, and they're doing it right there.
And they get to select their passion project. Mm-hmm. Nobody's telling them what project.
Right.
What's your passion?
What's your passion?
What do you love right. to do? And then from there, they teach them how to
To develop it, do the fundraising for it if need be, and get it completed and then present. Yeah. So very nice. Very, very nice job there.
I think also they I'm not sure, correct me on this one. They, in their passion project, if a charter school has affiliation with someone performing that, a career that the kids can go.
Yeah, they try to make that connection.
Like a co-op kind of thing.
Right, yeah. Right. Yeah. And so they attain experience and in some cases college credit.
They handle right. As well. They get college credit.
College credit. Yeah. But you're establishing, they're able to establish a relationship so early in the high at the high school level.
Exactly.
That I mean, you're setting up things for career bound. I mean, because people don't forget you. I mean, you know that. You know
that's network.
You know when you get done, right? You go to school. When you get done, you got a job. Come, you know, let's go. Yeah. I mean, so that's the type of connections they're doing.
Yeah.
So you know, which is
it's very fantastic, rare. Man. It's fantastic. Mm-hmm.
Speaking of another powerful motivator, Antoine Gay.
Oh yes, 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 yes.
Shout out to our guy Antoine down in Virginia and the work he's doing to help our youth get back on track, get a new start.
He is a committed
youth, not only youth but
right.
young adult. I mean, and so he works in the corrections department down in Virginia, Fredericksburg, and that's hard work. That's hard work.
You know, you really have to have a commitment when you're working with juveniles, you know, and young people, and they're coming at you sideways, thinking that you're the enemy, and in reality, you're really trying to point them in the right direction and help them, you know, have a quality of life, and they fight you every step of the way. Mm-hmm. You have to be committed to a project like that.
Oh yeah, and that takes.
I take my hat off to him.
Oh yeah,
that's amazing.
And not only on top of that, he's working on, you know, finalizing his book still, but I mean, it's going to happen. It's going
to
happen.
And I don't know if he would want us to
we're not, I mean, we're going to have him back on the show so he can really get in detail as you know, talk about what his book is about. Because, you know, we can say this. He is the brother of the late Marvin Gaye, the late great.
True, yeah.
So you can imagine. With that book, and how powerful and informative that book's going to be once it's released.
And you know, that's what makes him so special, because for him to be that committed to these kids or young men and young ladies and men, where he could be out trying to capitalize on his name.
Right. And he's not doing that. He's trying to make his own way.
He's trying to help someone else better their lives.
Right. Right.
That makes him special.
And just wants to say, and just wants to get the truth out.
That's all.
That's it.
That's all.
So definitely shout out to Antoine. Ken on acid sales. Oh man! I mean,
another amazing brother.
He took us now. He was part of the New York tour too, and he took us on a fantastic trip Roosevelt Island.
Roosevelt Island.
And how is just
a lot of history.
It's a different world. A lot of history with that. Yes. I mean, again, you know, I used to visit there when I was little. I mean, it was just dirt.
That was
dirt and grass. I mean, that wasn't. But today, it's a residence.
It's like, remember I told you guys, to me, it's like another upcoming Battery Park.
Right. Oh, yeah, there you go. Which is an upscale area of New York. Very nice. But the name always, we got.
I know.
The name because when you think about the name, you're like, Battery Park? What's that? What's that, a rundown? But no.
Blue Bloods.
Yeah, beautiful place. Yeah, beautiful place. And so is Roosevelt Island, how that has
evolved. I was very impressed with Roosevelt Island. That was my first time there. Very impressive.
It's like his own, like you know, you leave Manhattan, you going just into a whole different world.
It is.
All to
it
yourself.
It has a certain calm.
Right. A nice little community area. I mean, it's
little restaurants and...
Oh, yeah. Restaurants and really, they have just really built it up over there. Very impressive.
But you can kind of see the potential where it's going. That's why I say I compare it to Battery Park. I can see it going there.
Right.
Yeah.
And Ken is also an entertainer. He sings, he dances, he promotes.
Another Sammy Davis. Sammy Davis Jr. He does it all.
So he does it all, and he's good. Comedian.
Yes.
He's a funny guy.
Yes.
He's a funny guy, too. So yeah, that was a great interview and a great tour. I mean, him being a part of that and having the opportunity to go over there and check out what the revitalization of Roosevelt Island up in New York. So very nice.
Yes.
And he will be back on the show as well.
Okay.
You know, we'll have him back.
Yeah.
But I mean, some great people, some great connections, and it continues to grow.
Can't leave out the exceptional.
Oh, definitely not. Francine.
Because I thought about Ken.
That's right.
Remember
that's
Ken
right.
Rocked the house when we brought him on the exceptional school?
Like the
you know, you could hear a pin drop.
The ladies, wow.
He had their undivided attention.
Yes, he did. It got quiet.
Very knowledgeable, yes.
But shout out to Francine, the exceptional scribble show that launched this year as well. She was a part of another show, and she decided to branch off on her own. And she's done very well with that. I mean, it exposes artists, poetry, literary artists, and people in business too. So from, you know, she hits all those areas and puts a nice show together and exposes, similar to what we do, you know, exposes talent that you may know and you may not know.
Right.
And her show is every week. Comes out every Tuesday, so you know, check her out. She's also on Facebook. Her page is the Exceptional Snow. Exceptional Scribble Community. I'm combining people. So the Exceptional Scribble Community. That's the name of her page. And you can always go on her page on Facebook. You can see archive shows that she's already done. But really. She's really good at what she does.
She does. And she also she gets involved in self-publishing.
Yes. So she's done that through Amazon, through Amazon. Yeah. And her co-hosts do the same thing.
Oh, okay.
Nikki and Zipporah.
Yeah.
So that's the team. That's the team of three.
Okay.
But good show. Check it out if you haven't checked it out. Definitely, you can find out. If you're an upcoming artist, too, you can also find out information on how to get started.
True.
They're always talking about that.
Yeah.
You know, from us, we have appeared on there three times.
True that.
You get a sense of business related topics from us.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a nice program.
It's true.
Nice program. So yeah, people, we hope our intention is to touch people's lives all over. But we have to say, certainly that people have touched our lives.
It's been reciprocal, no doubt about it. Yeah.
And a good journey. Yeah. So, end of the year, holiday season, and you know this is always a fun time for us because it's some funny moments going on. You know, you know, when you get around Black Friday, we always look for, you know, what retail is going to start off with the sales. And so, but nobody's still, and I mentioned this before, nobody has started off on Monday yet. That's why I'm waiting to see. And I know it's coming.
It's coming.
Because you add Wednesday, Thursday.
It's coming.
You know, so, I mean, I'm waiting for who's going to do it first.
A Black Monday.
Because it happened. I mean, just go all week intense, 24 hours from Monday to Friday night.
Oh, you're talking about continuous.
Yeah, continuous.
Oh, so, okay.
You know, I mean,
you're talking about a day. Okay, you're talking continuous.
Somebody's going to do it. Somebody. Yeah, but one was good. I think one of the top ones this year was Old Navy. Now,
how so?
Everything in the store 50% off. Everything.
Wow.
Now, I don't think, and I could be wrong. I don't think another retailer has come off like that.
We have a window.
Yeah, I think it started for might have started at 4 o'clock Thanksgiving Day, and it'll end sometime tonight, Black Friday.
Oh, okay.
Maybe at the end of business. But everything, the entire store is 50% off. Now, you can think of somebody. I don't know. I don't think anybody's done that one.
That's a first.
That's a first. Yeah.
No doubt.
Right. So they might be this year's winner. We always try to think about who it is. But that's interesting. Yeah. I mean, and I guess, you know, I say price-wise, some things can be, pricey. I don't think not super price. Some things that they offer could be on a little pricey side, but no, I mean, overall, I would say they're pretty reasonable, I guess. I mean, but to have 50% off, man, that's interesting.
That sounds impressive.
Yeah.
Really impressive.
I mean, you know, and I'm sure they were busy today, between yesterday, last night, and today, so. Yeah. But everybody's in, you know, Walmart, Kmart, Target, everybody's doing their thing, Best Buy. You know, now what Best Buy does, they do for preferred members, like card members, card holders, stuff like that. They do like private events.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Like, you know, only exclusive to that. So you when you get there, of course you have to show
your card.
You know, your card, or you know, prove who you are, that you're a VIP member, and then you get opportunity to get so to speak special pricing, as opposed to what the regular public would be getting. During this time. So everybody has their, you know, thing. And then, of course, you know, anything you want to get. I mean, you know, it's all about, you know, the competition and who has the best sales and who has the best bargains and whatnot. But that takes, and that's good, I guess, from the business standpoint, but it's bad for the holiday because it kind of takes away from that. I mean, you know, they start off like 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Yeah. You're supposed to be hanging out with your family, having turkey and whatnot, or whatever you're doing, or celebrating. Instead, people, they eat, or some people camp out, and I guess maybe a family member brings them food, or others just eat early, and then they got to go camp out because you got to go get in line.
Right.
So, I mean, it's who's, like we said before, whoever's into that. I mean, that's great. If that's what you're into. I mean, I'm not privy to it myself.
You know, but I don't want to be a party for people, but, you know, the holidays is really supposed to be, like, you know, about faith.
Right.
You know, some people might have their perception about, you know, because some people say Christmas is not in the Bible, but I'm not going to go into that.
Right.
But the holiday is supposed to be, you know,
about family.
More about, you know, faith, about family. Right. And the cultural has become commercialized.
It most definitely has. You know,
I mean, to the point where that becomes almost like the depressing part, because you got people, you know, they take their little Christmas list from their kids and they're trying to fulfill the whole list. Why you can't just tell a kid, look, put two items on the
list? Right, Christmas.
You know what I'm saying? Right. People, their credit cards is like out the roof. Now you're depressed the rest of the year because you got to try to pay this off. I mean,
and you're absolutely right.
Out of control.
And from the business standpoint, it's like almost like a greed thing, because they're trying to get everything they can get to balance their books.
Exactly.
For the end
they get
of the year.
Black.
Yeah. So. So if they were doing bad during the year, I mean, this is the time, you know, where they're trying
to balance the books,
get that up.
Yep.
It's in everything, even car sales.
Exactly. Yeah.
So it's just wild. It gets a little crazy, but it's gotten a lot better, which is good to see. I mean, the control to how you know, Black Friday is dealt with, you know, across the board, you know, the protocols that are in place now and everything. So it's gotten a lot better in terms of control.
But still,
I mean, you know.
I'm impressed with, like you said, they have gotten a lot better with the management and the organization and the control of things. But going back to a point you made a moment ago about, you know, the holidays and primarily being a family day, you know, appreciating, the sales and what's available, but it's holidays were supposed to be a family day. This is when the family sit around, they bond.
Right.
And, you know, I know I'm dating myself. But this is when a family sat around, you bonded, you right. know, you had, you know, you ate a meal,
right.
you know, you shared that special moment. Mm-hmm. But now they got you going out on Friday, right. Black Friday, right. on Thanksgiving, mm-hmm. and with Christmas coming around, they got you going out to another sale, New Year's Eve, mm-hmm. Memorial Day. So they every holiday they got you going to the right. mall spending
right.
money.
Right.
You know, and
somehow, and it can diminish the true meaning. Of certain holidays.
I mean, when you give a family that right. those moments. I mean, even to the point. Once upon a time, before they came out with the blue law, mm-hmm. where you could open businesses on Sunday. Mm-hmm. Sundays used to seem it would be so quiet on the street, man. You wouldn't see any hard.
Yeah, hard. Right.
Businesses
right.
were shut down, right. and that was that family. You either went to church, or some families would sit around in their living room and have their Bibles, and they would have like a little mm-hmm. Bible study, whatever you want to call it. But the streets were like a ghost town.
Sure.
But now, man, right. the blue law came out and right. everybody can open
it. All that changed. That's right. Yeah. And some places still honor that. Look at that and at very high value, like Chick-fil-A.
Okay.
Closed
okay.
on Sundays.
Okay.
You don't work on Sundays
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I guess
it's
nature and the beast.
Yeah,
right,
that's true.
You know. But we hope that, and before I say this, I mean, also with the holidays too, it's time to catch up with people. With family,
yes.
you might not see
yes.
your family for
yes.
one. This
yes.
is the only time
yes.
you might see
yes.
somebody.
Yes,
you know. But then, you know, that's really about.
That's
I mean,
what
you
it's
know,
about,
I mean,
yeah.
and those are very special moments.
Exactly,
I mean, because
people are so busy.
Yeah,
you're working.
You know,
you're
working
raising
schedules.
Your kids, yeah.
Right. And yeah. Right. If you got children, you got other obligations and everything. It's hard to get
yeah.
away.
Yeah.
Work keeps you busy.
No doubt.
So,
And challenging.
Yeah. Right. So, I mean, this is really what these are the times where you can really get some bonding in, like
right.
you said.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, you know, that's just something to think
about.
Find out
what's going on
right.
with the kids and, you know, how things going in school.
Right. And that's the fun part.
Yeah.
That's the great part.
Because
yeah. right? a lot of people can take off around this time. So, you know, but that's something to think about, you know, something we like to reflect on. And then other fun things we like to talk about, like this is the breakup season. You know how it is.
You would have to go there.
You know,
the bitter with the sweet.
I get with you in the new year. Right now, we got to
hold that thought.
We need to take a moment to pause. You know, because the pockets ain't...
That is true. I've known guys to do that. That right around the holiday time, we
yeah.
break up season.
And it's, you know? I mean, it's.
But in this case, going back to what we talked episode, we had a couple episodes back about being slimy.
Right.
You know.
Yeah.
I mean, guys would, you know, because they would struggle with the fact that's when their player card
mm-hmm.
jams them up, because now they can't honor each one of the females that
right.
they're spending time
right.
with. Can't afford to.
Yeah. And so, you know, once again, going back to balancing the books, once I'm in the I'll give you a holler. Once the books are balanced again, we started off fresh. I'll give you a holler.
I'm in the red right about
now.
When I get in the black, I'll give you a holler.
Yeah, which is, I mean, you laugh, but yeah, I mean,
keep crying.
It's a horrible thing, though.
It is,
but it happens. I mean,
yeah.
people do it.
And
sometimes they get back together, and sometimes they just find
well,
start fresh again.
Yeah, that's true.
You
that's
know,
true.
New year, new person.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, but another I gotta mention this. One of our it's our fourth year doing it. One of our proudest moments, and that's the fried turkey episode.
Oh yes! Oh yes!
Woo!
Oh yes! Oh yes! Oh yes!
And it did.
I look forward to that.
That just
yes.
we get more. The more we do it, the better we get. We start off outside, and I think next year we need to go back outside, because it's been a couple years. We done a couple years outside. We done a couple years inside.
Man, the butterball indoor.
Yeah, I know.
Oh,
it's hard.
Man.
It's like once they came out with that, boy, it's just. It's just a lot easier. I mean,
you
it's
know,
great.
You can
I
do
mean,
so much with that.
Oh yeah, it's not just turkey.
Oh, man, I
oh, you
can
fry
so
ribs. You can fry chicken. You
can't you do vegetables too?
Vegetable steam, broiled steam.
Yeah, you know, what's that?
With the rack inside,
with the stick in the
yeah.
What do you call that?
The kibasi.
Is that
the,
it?
The
yeah.
No. Am I saying that right?
It seems like a
shish kebab.
Shish kebab.
Yeah. I bang it what you put on it to make it. But you could do that. I mean, it's
so
all
much with that.
And Butterball, you go online. I mean, it comes in the book too, the instruction book. But if you go online, they give you even more.
Oh, okay.
An array of recipes, of things to try that you can do. So it's not just turkey, but I mean, turkeys are, we're turkey. We're turkey experts.
That's top of the list. That's top of the list. Yeah.
I mean, we can't sell it more. I'm telling you, once you go fried, I don't know how you go back.
You can't go back.
We were just talking before we started here. Yeah, you know how you experienced some baked turkey last night.
Oh yeah.
So I mean you want to be, you know, you're going to eat. I mean, because you know the preparing everything is family. You know they prepared a nice meal, but. It's hard to not think about it. You feel like you're cheating on the fried turkey.
Exactly.
Like, oh, pass me the grape.
But then the other part of it is the fact how women used to slave.
Yeah.
Put the thing,
that time
be an overnight thing.
That time is slashed
in
half.
You got to put the gravy, what do you call it, base in it?
You gotta got to get up, you put it on, and it would be, I guess the maximum is 8 hours.
I don't know. It was
hours.
Exactly.
You had to set the alarm. You had to get up. And if you didn't do that and you let it cook and you came down.
Dry.
Boy, you get the saw out. But with frying, that's what makes it great.
Yes.
It's by minutes. Yes. I mean, you can cook a 20-pound bird 60 minutes in an hour. I mean, compared to 8.
What's it like? What's the
three to 4 minutes per pound.
Okay.
I mean, but and then it comes out. I mean, the outside is crispy like chicken. You know, chicken
like
skin. Inside the meat is just juicy. The whole thing, the white meat and the dark meat. And then it's flavorful. I mean, because depending on what your rub is, which we don't share that.
Well,
but
we can't share that with you.
I mean, you can really. I mean, the flavor sticks to the bird.
It certainly does. It does.
It's very good. I mean, it does, as opposed to the regular way, you're not going to have, in most cases, you're not going to have anything left.
No.
You're going to
eat. With fried turkey?
Fried turkey. It's going to be gone. I mean,
you in order to hope to have something left, you need security.
Yeah, I mean, because
we're rational. You have to ration it out. A slice for you.
We fall victim to that.
Right? Yeah.
Last year, not this year.
And it wasn't malicious.
No. Whoa. I mean, last year we did our fried turkey episode last year. Yeah. And so we got done and everything. And we had, don't forget the Hawaiian bread. That's probably what did it. I mean, both of them, you can't be alone and have both of them together.
You cannot.
Because what's going to happen, you're going to look down, it's going to be bones. And that's exactly what happened. We got to the end.
And we were just talking, man.
You know, started making little sandwiches with the Hawaiian bread. Another hour went by before it was said and done. We looked down like, oh.
And we barely had a caucus.
Boy. Needless to say, there were some choice words.
We took a hit on that one.
But it is that good.
It's that good.
And something that we're probably doing because not only we do a nice bird, but we show you how to do it safely.
Yes.
So and that's important because remember, you know, if you recall when turkey frying was just starting to become popular, there were a lot of major incidents. People were too close to their house. They were dropping in the bird in the grease and. The next thing you know, you have this fire. Yeah. It became horrific. I mean, you don't want that. I mean, you want to be able to do it and do it safely,
right?
And come out with a finished product. But it has gotten the training and the education behind it has gotten a lot better. And we pride ourselves on sharing in that knowledge to pass off. If you're not familiar with doing it, how to do it, and we have fun with that. This year was a little special because we had. Our honorary member on, and this time, usually we just do the turkey. This time we had a dessert to go with the turkey, which was very good. It was called sand pie.
Yes.
Are you familiar with dirt pie?
Sand pie is
using Oreo cookie as opposed to the dark cookie, the chocolate cookie.
Yes, that was tasty.
So it was very tasty.
Yeah.
So as we build on that, you know, continue with that, we'll add more to that program. and tell you not only just have it on air and do it ourselves, but we'll tell you how to make it.
Exactly.
So you know you can try it out for yourselves. But I mean, but
except for the rub.
Except for the rub.
That's off limits.
Yeah, we can't tell you. You got to come up with your own thing, you know. And it's not hard, you know, whatever you like, you know, or you know, get an idea from people, the you know, family members, you know, and make your combination. But we can't share some things. We just can't share.
No, nothing personal.
But again, a fantastic year. We absolutely thank everyone all over. Where No Notes is broadcasted, where people check us out. We thank you for your support. We know we need that in order to stay in existence. And we want to improve. We want to get better. So we need your feedback as well.
That's where you come in.
That's right. So although we're ending for the season, we're still looking for feedback, your suggestions, your comments. Please let us know what you think of what we're doing. Or what you might want to know about, because we're open.
Yeah.
You know, we can't. There's so many topics out there. You know, we can't think of them all.
True that.
You know, so we can use a little help too. Say, hey, what are you interested in?
Exactly.
What do you want to know about? Yeah. We'll look into it for you, and bring it back.
We do the research for you.
Yeah, there you go. Because that's what we do.
That's what we do.
That's what we do. You know, and we have fun doing this. Yeah. I mean, this is No Notes is family owned and something we're very proud of and something that we have built and continue building and just looking to continue to be prosperous as we move forward.
Yes.
So with that, before we go, we'd like to wish everyone a happy holidays for the entire holiday right now.
And safe holiday.
We're in the midst of Thanksgiving. You know, Christmas is coming up, New Year's is coming. Yes, please be safe. Especially on New Year's. I mean, you know, it's all right. Actually, you might want to consider just doing your own party at home. That way you don't have to drive, you don't have to go anywhere, you don't have to be out there.
Yeah.
But for those that do go out, be safe. Choose your place of venue wisely, you know, and the company you keep. That's important. I mean, you know, be careful out there because, I mean, people still crazy.
True that.
You know, yeah, we still have not gotten away of the shooting the guns in the air and all. I mean, what? I don't understand what that's about.
Just being reckless.
Yeah, I mean, because what goes up has to come down. And see, that's where people get hurt.
Exactly.
You know, you thinking, you know, you popping the gun.
It's going to dissolve or something.
Right, yeah, it disappeared. No, I mean, it could come down. It could hit an innocent bystander driving by, walking by, ricochet off something. It could hit you.
True that.
You standing there, pop, and the next thing, right back into your head or something. I mean, there's no need for that. Go out. It's all right to go out and have a great time. And watch your drinking. Keep your drinking to a minimum. I mean, because you
have a designated driver.
Yeah. I mean, be considerate not only for yourself, but for others as well that are traveling out there. But in all that you do, enjoy and be safe and be positive, because that's what we're about. And we're going to continue to spread that message into the 2015 season. Some great things are coming up.
And beyond.
You know, we're talking about doing something real big for next year, and we're working on it, and this time it will happen.
No Notes
is going to be throwing a party, a big one.
Yes.
But more to come on that. But
Big L.
Yeah, that's going to be, that's probably one of our biggest events.
In the Big Apple.
In the Big Apple for next year.
Yeah.
And, you know, we'll continue to come up with good topics.
Yeah.
And try, each year we try to work on changing our programming, what we do, to enhance it, because we like to keep it fresh and keep you up to date as well.
Right.
So, some great things to come in 2015, but first and foremost, it's all because about the man upstairs, it's all about God, and we're blessed to be here, and we're mindful and prayerful that we will be here to continue this, and God willing, He will allow us to be. So, without further ado, we're going to get ready to close out. As always, you know how to get in contact with us. Give us a call, 610-626-0454. That's our number. You can email us at thenonoshowall.com. You can go to our website and sign our guest book. Check out our website. Let us know what you think about our website. That's all new this year. www.thenonoteshow.com. And of course, we got our Facebook business page, our group page. We're on YouTube, got our YouTube channel. We got our SoundCloud channel, and we're on WordPress. So plenty of places to go. No excuses.
No excuses. No excuses.
Not to know, not to find where No Notes is.
Yep.
On top of that, just searching through the regular venues, the search engines, Bing and Ask and AOL and Yahoo and MSN. We're accessible.
Yeah.
Accessible. So please, we invite you to check us out and afford the opportunity for you to taste the No Notes experience.
Okay.
And speaking of that, we might have a new slogan last year. To be announced. Something else we working on.
To be announced.
But we let me put this out. Let's put this out. if you got an idea on a good slogan, send it to us.
Sure.
And we might have a little prize for you. Yeah.
I just thought about that.
Yeah. Okay. Send it to us. You know. You might something like a nice embroidered no shirt. You know, check out the back.
I'm getting twisted.
You know. Uh huh. And then you can spread the word that way, just walking around, because people stopped us.
Okay.
You know, one time I was in the car, and you know, the license plate says No Notes. A woman got actually pulled her car in park in traffic. I mean, we were stopped at a traffic light. Got the car. She said, "I just got asked, what is No Notes?" See, it's attractive.
It is.
It's catchy. Yeah. It's eye catching. I mean, people want to know what it is. I mean, you can walk around like
what's up,
and you'll be versed.
Yeah,
you'll be well versed. You want to know what it is? I'll tell you. And this is how you can check it out.
I can show you better.
So, and we appreciate that. We need that.
Yes.
In order to continue our succession as a family business on the rise. So, and that's what we are. And it's all because of you. We certainly thank you for all that you do. So,
I did all that.
Again, be safe during this holiday season. Enjoy family. Remember what it's about.
Exactly.
Family and love and blessings.
Right.
And gifts. We're not knocking doing nice things for people or even for yourself for that matter. But remember what it really means. It's not about the material.
Right.
Absolutely not. It's about the human element.
Yes.
And life itself. Appreciate life. Because every day is never guaranteed. So appreciate being here. We certainly do. That's why we like to bring you what we bring you.
I like this.
Yep, there you go. So that's it for us.
Yep, another one in the can.
Happy holidays. Happy New Year. We'll see you in the new year 2015 for some more of the No Notes Show.
No Notes Show.
Doc.
Keep it safe.
Yep, it's going to close this out as always.
We'd like to wish you peace, love, and soul.
We'll see you in 2015. Be good.